This past weekend, many Democrats came out demanding that Jared Kushner's security clearance be revoked in light of the new information showing that he attempted, allegedly, to establish some kind of back channel communication between the Trump administration, the Trump campaign, I should say, and Russian intelligence officials. Now, many Democrats have come out and said this is clearly an act of espionage, but not Cory Booker. No, that 2020 presidential candidate wannabe actually appeared on the Sunday talk shows this weekend to say, no, I don't think we need to rush to revoke Jared Kushner's security clearance. I think we need to go ahead and let the investigation play out. I'm not jumping on the Trump impeachment bandwagon right now. Well, one thing Cory Booker didn't mention during those Sunday talk show appearances while he's defending Jared Kushner is the fact that in 2013, according to a report in the International Business Times by David Sirota, in 2013, Cory Booker took $41,000 for his senatorial campaign from the Kushner family. In 2009, he took another $20,000 from the Kushner family. So this is a man who's taken more than $60,000 from Jared Kushner and his family's companies. And now he's going out there saying, whoa, slow down there, folks. Maybe this isn't quite espionage. I mean, Cory Booker is out there using the same kind of talking points as Tucker Carlson. And yet I'm sure there's plenty of establishment Democrats out there today saying, well, Cory Booker, hey, 2020, we got this, right? He's our guy. He's going to be the Democratic savior to put the Democratic Party back on the map. Lead us down that more progressive path. A man who takes money from Republicans, Republicans embroiled in scandals at this point, a man who votes against the importation of cheaper and oftentimes safer prescription drugs from Canada on the grounds that they're not safer because he's taken a lot of money from the pharmaceutical industry. Cory Booker is not the Democratic Party savior. He's everything that's wrong with the Democratic Party. Cory Booker represents every problem that those of us who are serious about progressive politics are trying to fix. We're trying to get that corporate money out of there so it stops influencing votes like the one Cory Booker gave earlier this year. We're trying to get that corporate money out so politicians stop protecting people who break the law, which is what this Kushner money's doing. People need to understand the truth about Cory Booker. And the truth is that this man better go ahead and just register as a Republican because he fits more in line with what that party is trying to do, with the exception, I guess, on social issues. But when it comes to voting for corporations, protecting corporations instead of people, Cory Booker is right there with the Republicans, voting almost every time to protect the interests of the people who put him in office. Again, that is everything that's wrong with the Democratic Party. That has everything to do with why the Democrats ran in 2016. And if they want to lose again in 2020, then they need to go ahead and start making those Cory Booker for president yard signs, because that is exactly what will happen. Cory Booker at the top of a ticket or anywhere on a ticket for president, given his history, given the people he's taken money from, will cause the Democrats to lose in 2020 without a doubt. If you like this video, make sure that you like, comment, and share, and most importantly, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you want to help support Ring of Fire, go to patreon.com/theringoffire. Become a monthly patron to help support independent progressive media.